Right, this is going to be a video about the lifts in het Groot Handelsgebouw and also a little bit about the building, just mixed in for variety, because I'm a structural engineer and when I see some structural engineering stuff, I'll comment about that as well. But this building has many old freight lifts from Bakker en Reuep, also known as Machinefabriek Breda. And I came to the idea by watching a video from Alexander Weder of Heritage Elevators. He inspired me to go to Rotterdam, even though it was quite a long trip. Yeah, this building in advance is very noisy. Sadly, there are a lot of locked off parts that are kind of hard to get into, but one thing I really noticed whilst editing the video is that the HVAC system is incredibly loud. So I hope you aren't too annoyed by that. I personally find it very annoying that there's so much noise in a building, especially if it's a work environment. And it's not just a car park, but even one of the stair landings, just one of the staircases that opens to the outside is very noisy for some reason. So yeah, that's something in advance I want to point out. The passenger lifts, they are nothing special, although I filmed a few. They're just modernized and quite generic. Yeah, they're not really worth the effort, but yeah, there's at least about six old nice lifts, even though I filmed maybe three of them. There's a few other things that I want to show before we start the video, and it has something to do with the door interlocks, because they have been replaced, and originally they may have been different. Let's take a look. So, I found something about those door interlocks in this book. I have reviewed this book, well, a few years ago. It's an old book about lift technology. And yeah, this has a description of door interlocks. And the lifts in this building are from this company, Bakker en Reuep. Although I sometimes mispronounce it and I call it Bak en Reuep, but it should be Bakker en Reuep, of course. Also known as Machinefabriek Breda. And before we take a look at the door interlocks, this is a schematic diagram of it. But I need to show something first. This is an old passive door interlock. Just for a bit of perspective, this is not the type of interlock that those lifts originally had. They already had modern active interlocks, but they were a little bit of a different design. And the design was a bit like this. Nowadays you've got those Smeerzaal or Kronenberg interlocks that are very compact and easy to install and easy to retrofit. But these large goods lifts, they have a lock called a spagnolet lock. And it's basically a vertical latch, as it is. And it is manually operated. And this vertical bar basically locks the door in place so that it can't move if something hits against it. It ensures that it's firmly closed. That by itself is not the interlock, but the interlock interacts with it. And it's installed in the top part of the door frame, in this bit here. You find this mechanism. This is the cam with the roller, and it, it kind of retracts against this, and that's well activated by a solenoid that's on the lift cap, and then it well, operates this latch. But this latch over here apparently locks this vertical latch in place. But this original vertical mechanism has been disabled. They only kept the vertical locking bit. And this original latch has been removed and replaced by a modern latch. So yeah, that's something I just wanted to point out, and yeah, let's start the video. Zo, hier we are, het Groot Handelsgebouw in Rotterdam. En from what I've heard, there are some interesting old goods elevators in this building, like this one over here. Yeah. This one has really interesting old interlocks. For instance, it's got these like automatic closing things. And yeah, this one is vintage. Apparently that side is not usable. And well, Heritage Elevators has also filmed these lifts. And these are built by Bakken Reubeck, because there is a logo over there. Of course, these lifts are without inner doors. It's going a lot further down. Right, let's open this. So let's have a look. So this is the first lift. This is Goederen Lift B, and it's got these really nice old locks, as you can see. Also, this one apparently has photo cells, and well, here's some information. So let's write it again. Oh, somebody wanted to use it, so I think I'll go down quickly. I'll send it down straight away. So let's first take a look at the other side of the lift. Here the doors seem to be blocked out, as you can see. There's no windows on that side, although originally there may have been windows, judging by the way it looks. So, that was the first lift, and now there are apparently some more lifts, like the one over there. So apparently this building has a lot of goods lifts. Let's take a look at this one. This one is very big, as you can see. And somebody left the doors open. But here you can see, oh, this one has really heavy doors. Here you can see the old mechanism, and if I do this with my finger, like so, this will move, and it also moves the knob on the outside. So a very nice old vintage design. So let's see if this one will arrive as well. So, and this one also has a window, as you can see. So let's ride it. And also, it seems like they installed some photo cells for safety reasons. This one has really large doors. But yeah, Alexander Wede of Heritage Elevators has also filmed them, and he inspired me to go visit this place. ...2300 kilograms capacity. But yeah, the fixtures are modernized. So now let's take a look at this window. Stand here.
Yeah, it was quite a long train trip to get here from Hengelo. Almost 2 hours. In fact, it was more than 2 hours. There you can see a counterweight. Well, let's go to some random floor. I'll put the camera like so. Sadly, the cab is a little bit shallow. You can definitely feel that the drive system has been modernized. So I am now at a random floor. I must say these doors are very heavy, and this is what the building looks like. So open the doors like so. So that is our open lift. Yeah, this one has just a fixed knob that you cannot turn. Also, it looks like it may have originally got that same sort of locking mechanism. Here you can see where the where the door will latch. That's a latch point. And there should be the interlock. This here is the door interlock. And that's the part that locks this bit. So this is the thing that kind of moves. So now let's go up. I must say this one rides very smoothly. The drive mechanism and the controller definitely have been modernized. It seems like they replaced the old relay system. Right, now let's see if there are any more lifts. This is goods lift number E. It seems like there's another lift over there that is not accessible. I don't know what that is. That looks like a passenger elevator. Let's see if that is accessible. Yeah, it seems like these are modernized lifts. Don't know the manufacturer, but it looks like a generic one. This one says a Sona lift, or just a passenger elevator. I must say it's not particularly quick. Who built this one? Well, it doesn't even say. So it's probably generic. No, let's just go to a slightly lesser floor. Yeah, this one is nothing interesting. It doesn't have any of that old character. I reckon that originally this might have been in a doorless lift as well, perhaps. But yeah, they just lack the character that the old lifts have. Yeah, this one wasn't interesting. Now let's see if there are any other good old lifts here. Here's a picture of what the building looks like originally. This is the Groothandelsgebouw. It seems like there's another lift over there, but it doesn't appear to have any call buttons. So this one might be disabled for some reason. Let's see, it's a bit dark. No, there's no call buttons here. But we can, however, look at the shaft, but it's too dark, unfortunately. Well, this place is very big. According to Alexander Wede, there are about six passenger... No, correction, there are about six goods lifts in this building. They all are that vintage Bak & Reubeck design, and there's one that appears to have a locked off call fixture. And there's another one next beside it. So that is number B, we've already wrote that one. And that's another one with a different door design. And this one also has a sort of manual closer. Yeah, AKB Lift Service, that's a generic company from Amersfoort. They have modernized these. Anyway, I'm glad that they kept those old freight lifts. I don't see much action going on, to be fair. Don't see any counterweight moving, so I wonder if this one is disabled. It does light up. It lights up, but I don't see any action going on. So that one, I think, is probably disabled. And this one we used to ride, but here the call fixture is locked. So let's try this one then. This one has no call fixture. Also disabled. So I think we've had most of them. Let's just take a look at this car park. I must say this car park is quite big and the structure is very like old school. They even made a cutout in this beam. Although it's not in a particularly good place judging from a structural point of view, because I am a structural engineer, and that is not a good place to make an opening in the beam. Yeah, very old-fashioned design this, because more modern car parks typically would have a flat slab without any beams. Yeah, this is just a very vintage structure in a lot of ways. Oh, I see another good lift in the distance, number C. So let's check that. And there's also a passenger elevator. This one has a locked off call fixture. Yeah, this one has no call fixture. This one is also disabled, and there's two other goods lifts over there that cannot be accessed. This one's also locked off, at least on this floor. Yeah, this one definitely moves. This one is also quite small. Oh. It seems like it skips two floors. It doesn't go to the ground floor, but it goes to the second floor. Yeah, that's old floor, that's disabled. Right. Right, floor number two. Right. Let's just take a look at this building for a bit and see where the exit is. Oh, there's the other large lift. Oh, this is the one with the window and the shaft. Yeah. It is a floor below. Oh, this one is actually locked off. There's another one that is doesn't have a coal fixture. Again, this one is disabled. And this is, I think, the main exit. You can look outside. So, there you have it. That was the lifts. At the Groot Handelsgebouw. Oh, actually, I do see another passenger elevator, but it's on a stair landing. This looks somewhat interesting. There's two lifts, and they respond very slowly. I caught one, but it's not responding. Oh, turns out it's this one. Yeah, it doesn't say who built it. Actually, 1968. So this lift already wasn't original and it has been modernized again. So it has been modernized at least twice by the looks of it. Yeah, because this building dates from early 1950s, so it was modernized already about 10 years after this building was built. And here's the rear entrance.